Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video with the awesome Muff. Today we're going to be reviewing the new version of the T32. Now, new veterans out there that have been playing for like 6 months, probably more, would remember that the T32 used to be absolutely crap. It used to be 152mm thick. Not anymore. It's 298. This is the king of hold down. Or the queen. It depends how you view it. It could be a she. I'll do that. So the T32, she has a 105mm gun. DPM is 1500. I'm pretty sure that is a little bit better than it used to be. Average pen is the same. Acceleration rate is obviously different because of the new update. Top speed is better? I think health points is 1,550. I think that's changed by 50 hit points. I'm not entirely sure. I think I'm going to have to look back into my old T32 review video and have a look. 260mm of frontal armor. That's changed. That's been made better. 298mm of frontal turret armor. Don't aim for the turret cheeks. It's not going to go through. Don't aim for the cupola. Not going to go through. Don't aim for the gun mallet. Not going to go through. this thing is broken. It's got 10 degrees of gun depression, so you can sit on like a little incline, or you can just, I don't know, just don't show your hole. People are going to have a really hard time trying to get through your armor. So, let's go in a battle and have a look how this thing performs. That's a nice amount of gun depression. Oh, and also, if anybody's curious, if anybody's struggling with how I actually got the turret, you hold C to hold, hold C to lock your turret. You actually get more gun depression when you go into sniper mode. That's interesting. Somebody's using the Super Showman because, hey, Scrub Lord, Super Showman's model's been updated. That looks different. The gun actually looks bigger. Excuse me? You wanna go, mate? Come on, boy. Oh, he's dead. He did quite a bit of damage to us, this. Always try and pin my turret, I dare ya. E100 may be able to get through our turret. Not entirely sure. I don't think he will be able to get through our turret. If he does that, then yeah, of course he can get through our turret because our hole. Oh, he's dead. Oh, we've lost. Of course we're gonna lose. How did that work? T10 is the same. I'm sure the T10 is the same. If Greg has sneaked in a little package. No, it's the complete same. 260 front, 157mm of frontal turret armor. Turret armor is actually garbage on this tank, actually. The T32, oh boys. So Basically, this thing is stupid. There's somebody that actually has the same flipping character as me. And I wish you could actually stop doing that, because it's kind of annoying me. So the E100 spam is just bloody real. It really is. It's just like, ever since it's been buffed, everybody's been using E100. Not everybody, but most people have been using E100. But this tank is just bloody good at hold down. I mean, first of all, you have 300mm of gun man armor. Then you have to get through 298mm of front and tail armor, so that's 598mm of armor. That's a humongous amount of armor. Oh, hello. Oh, okay. He's like, what the fuck? So where is it? Oh. I don't want him to hit my hole. The reload is a little bit worse than it used to be. I think that's a balance factor in there. And I think, I'm not touching you, I don't know, I think I'm stupid. Just threw that right into the ground. He's gonna pop up again. Don't aim for me. Oh, thank you for that, lad. Ooh, gee. Thingy, magic door. Did that go over him? Wow, this guy thinks he's just invulnerable in the Centurion. Does he not understand that the top of the Centurion 71's turret is a weak spot? It's a weak spot. So, keep that in mind, mate. You can try and pen my turret, you ain't gonna get through it. Oh, there's E50, that's when you flipped yourself. Oh. This is the tactic you want to use in the T32. You just want to make sure they can't hit your hole. Oh, wow. He's going to rage about that. Don't show your hole. What was he thinking? Oh, I'm going to show my hole. Oh. Nah, mate, you don't show your hole. Oh, okay. I'm just gonna track. Oh. Hello! You can try and get through my turret, maybe you ain't gonna do it. Oh, he's dead. Oh, wow, really? It hit a tree? Oh my god, that's so broken. Everybody's just trying to shoot me right now, and it's just, I think everybody now really fears the T32. Like, it's just so, actually it's a machine where you when it used to first have its stupid retarded turret on, it was bad. I mean, yeah, you could get a couple of good bounces on the gun mantlet, but still. Now, there is a thing where, because you've got 598mm of armor combined with the gun mantlet and the front of the turret combined, you get 598. You do have a chance to bounce, wait for it, to bounce an MBT-70, because I've bounced an MBT-70 when he shot my gun mantlet. That was interesting. I had to actually look into that. The MBT-70 has, if I'm correct, 534mm of pen. So he won't even be able to spawn me. That's how ridiculous this thing is. This thing has nearly 600mm of frontal turret armor combined with the gun mantlet. Insane. Come on, boys. So, yeah, this thing is, broken. It's only 2mm off of like, having, like, you know, modern tank armor. I mean, your typical modern tank will have probably have about 650 to 700mm of frontal turret armor. Oh, I see a hello. Now, if you have two T32s, that go hold down on each team. Oh, come on! Come on, aim. Sorry. I wish there was, like, you know, a little indicator, a little plus sign or something, or an X sign that actually told you where to hit the fucking target. Like the shell drop and everything like that. I'm gonna stay in this exact position because you never know. I feel like there's somebody sneaking around. I'm so bad at shooting. I don't know. I think because tanks have accuracy, obviously. In real life, they do sort of have accuracy because the shell, you know, it doesn't go where you want it to go most of the time. Of course it's going to hit the target, but it doesn't hit where you want it to hit. So, like, say you're aiming for the turret, and you have a fairly inaccurate gun, like, say, the IS gun. You fire, it's probably going to hit the hole. That's how inaccurate it can be. Oops, somebody just fired the main gun. Now, I think he may be able to spawn us. Wow, he bounced off the ass of an M4 pump. Got him. Oh. Tank. Did he he bounced off. You will not pen me. You're dead. You are so dead, mate. Would you piss off, mate? Seriously. I mean, it does feel like a very strong machine. Don't you dare pen my front armor. Okay, I'm just gonna kill the centurion in front of him. Okay, he dinged off our front arm, that's good. Yay, we won! Okay, we hit the we got 3 kills out of that. 3 gold. Pretty nice, actually. So, I mean, it's like, the T32, I definitely would say, it is definitely a tank you want to get now. It's definitely a nice looking machine. The gun looks longer. I think Greg may have put a new 105 on, because the last 105 always I think it's probably the same 105 mil, but if it is, he's probably buffed the penetration and the explosive mass of the shell. Basically, for example, let's take the E100, right? It's got 128mm shell. It fires a AP what's it? APCBC shell. I had to think there for a second. And it's got a pretty large explosive mass in the shell. That's why the E100 does so much damage per shot. I mean, I've hit for 600 in this thing before. And people say that the E100 is pretty crap because it does less damage than the E5. The E5 has a 120mm gun, and yet the E100 reloads faster than the E5. And I've proven that it reloads faster than the E5 because I had a spar, like a fight against the E5. And he had the same crew level, he had crew level 14. I reloaded faster than him, I do more damage than him. I don't have more penetration than him, he's got far better penetration because he fires APHEBC, I think it is. Armor piercing high explosive ballistic cap. So of course it's going to have more penetration. But you're not going to get through the front of this machine. I mean, if you hit the gun mantlet, you're stupid. If you hit the turret cheeks, you may have a chance of spoiling that target. I mean, of course, the T-120D5 is going to spoil the target. If he hits the gun mantlet, he ain't going to do anything. Your best chance is to rush this tank. Rush this tank. Just rush it. If you've got, like, a far shot, then shoot over it, like if he's like, you know, poking over a like a mound or a hill or something like that, just fire and hope that it hits his hull, because then it should do some damage. If it doesn't, then maybe do some plunging fire into his turret, see if that works. It should work. Now going over to the Centurion Mark 7. Now the weak spot I was talking about is this weak spot here. I've noticed that the hitbox for the gun mantler doesn't extend up anymore. It just stops here. So this is a weak spot. So if you hit here, you're gonna do a lot of damage. So you don't have that amazing 289mm protecting this part anymore. It's just 89mm. So if you want to, if you don't have 200 millimeters of pen, just aim here, and you should be able to damage him over and over and over and over again, and it'll really, really annoy him. And that's how that other guy died from that T-30-45, because that T-30-45 kept on hitting here. I mean, I saw those shells, and they were just going in and in and in and in and in, and he killed him. I mean, of course, T-30-45, what is it, like, yeah, 139mm pen. So, I mean, he doesn't have a chance to spawn on the gunman itself. He may have probably hit, like, here, because, I mean, he was at angle, the Centurion 7. He was at angle like that. He may have probably, because the, it's like, just be careful with this weak spot right here. I'm not gonna actually shut this guy up because he is spamming. I'm gonna defend him, unfollow him, and block him. There you go. So, the Centurion Mark 7-1 isn't as effective as it used to be, but it's still pretty effective. So going back to the T32, because I know that you guys want me to review the new T32. It's a brilliant machine, absolutely brilliant when it's hold down. This is not a weak spot. I've had people aim for here, like people that I think have been playing mod attacks and they thought, oh, yeah, Coppola. Weak spot, let's hit it. It doesn't pen, and they're like, it's just like, well, it doesn't pen, and then like, why is it gonna pen? It's because, boys and girls, it's because the hitbox for the frontal frontal turret armor extends to the I'm focusing on chat and I'm losing my losing my thoughts, and I really do apologize. I really, really, really do apologize for that. It extends up to the cupola, so the cupola is not a weak spot, so just, you know, remember that. Now, somebody did suggest, it was Greg that suggested that I write down everything before I talk about it. I forgot to do that for this review, and I really do apologize if I stutter and things like that. But the gun is amazing. 254mm of pen with a, I believe it's an armor-piercing ballistic cap, APBC shell, or it's an APHBC, APHUBC. It's probably an APHUBC because it's got, like, you know, it's got better damage than it used to before it got buffed. So, I don't know. I don't know what you guys think about this tank. I really do like the new buff to the T32. The buff to the 100. Where's this turret? There it is. I like it. I really do. I love the reload of this gun. I mean, you can out DPM every high tier heavy tank. Not the high tier medium tanks. I did not say the high tier medium tanks. I said the high tier heavy tanks. Like, you can out DPM the Conqueror, you can out DPM the T125. T32, I believe you can out DPM 1700, 1900. So it can out DPM the T32, the T34, the T125, and things like that. But it can't out DPM the T28, and that's the problem. So I mean, if you come across the T28, be prepared to get absolutely smashed. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up. If you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs down. Put in the comment section what you think about this T32, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.